Expanded polypropylene, expanded polystyrene. They are everywhere in this world. They are everywhere we look. Every day we use these polymers and most of us don't even notice. Welcome to Spex Lite Learning. Today we learn the difference between EPP and EPS. First, let us break it down. According to dictionary.com, poly is used to form the names of polymers by being attached to the name of the base unit of which the polymer is made. For all the bookworms out there, propylene is an unsaturated organic compound with the chemical formula CH3CH equals CH2. Styrene. Styrene is an organic compound with the chemical formula C6H5CH equals CH2. But what does that mean? Polypropylene is a synthetic, semicrystalline thermoplastic polymer that's used in many industrial and domestic applications, which makes it great for the automobile industry. While expanded polystyrene is a rigid, closed-cell, thermoplastic foam material produced from solid beads of polystyrene, which make it great to package many types of products. Now let's find out some characteristics and how we use these polymers in our daily lives. The first thing is that EPS and EPP is they are 98% air and they don't absorb water. They also are both lightweight. And they are not hazardous materials. Lastly, EPP and EPS can both be recycled. Now let's go over the differences. Starting with EPP or expanded polypropylene. This happens to be more durable. EPP also has greater heat and chemical resistance. It is less brittle and more elastic than EPS. All this makes it used more for heavier duty items. These features allows for EPP to be used the whole interior of your car and you may not have ever realized it. Next, let's look at EPS or expanded polystyrene. When you think of EPS, think of styrofoam. EPS is lower in cost compared to EPP. EPS can go smaller and lighter. EPS also has more color variations. So where is EPS used most in your daily lives? Packaging is the biggest use because it has good impact resistance along with great insulation properties. For example, have you ever received groceries from an online delivery service? Well, it's packaged all in EPS to keep the food safe and cold. So in summary, EPP and EPS are everywhere in the world we live. They are some of the most common plastics in use today. EPP and EPS uses have endless possibilities. Thanks for watching Spex Lite Learning. I hope you learned at least one thing about EPS and EPP today. For future learning videos, please like and subscribe.